Pacific Islands are among the most vulnerable nations in the world to the adverse impacts of climate change. They are working together to develop information systems that can improve their adaptation and resilience planning efforts.
Well, information is it's very, very important. I must say that, you know, information is power. If you need to defeat your enemy, you need to know a lot of information about your enemy, where they are, who they are. At this age, our enemy is climate change. For us to fight against climate change, we need to know what climate change is, possible impacts, and all of that, so that we can be better prepared and we can better adapt to the impacts of climate change.
Information is very critical to support the policymakers and the decision makers in adaptation and mitigation planning. This is a need that has been identified year after year in every SPREP meeting, in every gathering, the need to support our members so that they could discover, manage, and importantly, share and apply information, so that their decision making could lead towards climate resilience, improvement of living standard, livelihoods, and so forth.
We're very fortunate here at Griffith University to be provided funding by the Commonwealth Department of Foreign Affairs and Trade to work with a Pacific regional organisation called SPREP. We're working with them to implement a regional approach to climate change data and information management in the South Pacific region. So the Pacific iCLIM project is working with three countries in the South Pacific, Fiji, Vanuatu and Tonga. It's helping them develop essentially information and knowledge management plans. We've worked with them to enhance their national climate change data portals, and these are critical for delivering content and information to governments in the Pacific. We're also working with SPREP at the regional level to develop a regional portal and enhance that for the countries. Part of that is connectivity between those devices, so we've developed something that's called a federated search, which enables content to be shared across the region among these devices.
The Pacific Climate Change Portal is intended to be a starting point for users to access resources that are available in the Pacific. There are already over 1,000 documents in the Pacific Climate Change Portal. But through the federated search, users will have access to over 13,000 resources.
The training today from the iCLIM project is very helpful because we get to know the details of how to put information into the portal. The portal is important to the community because that's where we share information for them so that they can be aware of the situation of climate change here in Tonga.
Governments and organizations in the Pacific should support the Pacific Climate Change Portal because climate change is a cross-cutting issue. Having support for the portal and having the right data and information in the portal and access to the right data and information will enable decision makers to make informed decisions.
If you have done something on community profiling, any reports regarding community that is useful for the citizens of this country or elsewhere to have access to, make it available. People need to have access to those information. So it is really important that we have those documents, people to have access to and make use of it.
Then our portal provides very good insights into the climate change information and disaster risk reduction. And in many ways, it avoids the chances of us, reinventing the wheel, because what we are trying to do, maybe other countries are already doing it, and we can just learn from them. We don't have to start from scratch.
I think having this website available for us and also other departments, we can use to work together. If, like for example, for tourism or climate change, so we can go directly to the website instead of trying to go through the reports and like finding out information ourselves.
Donors have spent a lot of money on big projects, adaptation projects, and most of those projects cover things like baseline studies or generally the risk analysis of vulnerability studies. It is really, really important that we have to make sure that these reports are reused for future projects, the implementation, because projects that will be coming, they need this type of information.
Pacific Island countries and territories are making good progress in developing important climate change information systems. Accessing and utilising the information and knowledge in these systems will be critical to addressing the climate change challenges facing the region.